do you find local scholarships? Well, I'm going to teach you in this video, and trust me, there are some tips and advice in this video that you do not want to miss. What's going on? It's your girl Danielle Jeffers. I'm the founder of Doe 4 Degrees LLC. Doe 4 Degrees is a scholarship coaching company where I teach students how to earn scholarships to go to college and graduate debt-free. I graduated debt-free from Virginia Tech on May 17th of 2019, having earned more than $200,000 in scholarships. And in a video I shot a few weeks ago called The Best Scholarships to Apply For, I told you there are two different types of scholarships you should definitely focus on applying for. Local scholarships, because you have a higher chance of winning them, and then the scholarships that fit you best based on your scholarship profile. So maybe you're great in the classroom, so you have a great GPA and you want to apply for academic-based scholarships, or you have a great story, you overcame a childhood hardship or an obstacle, and you do very well when you talk about that in an essay, and you want to focus on scholarships that ask you to talk about that. Those are the two best types of scholarships to apply for: local scholarships and the scholarships based on your profile. Now, on this YouTube channel, I will give you more tips and advice about how to find scholarships based on your profile. But for now, we're going to focus on local scholarships. So how do you find local scholarships? Well, when I was applying for scholarships, it was a process I learned through trial and error. I tell y'all very often that I won more than $100,000 in scholarships in 5 months as a high school senior. I applied for more than 30 scholarships during that time and won 14 of them, totaling more than $100,000. But that required a lot of work. I'm from Danville, Virginia, which is a small city. It's an independent city on the border of North Carolina. It's located in South Central Virginia. Now, Danville is not as technologically advanced as some other cities and areas, so I had to call people. I had to go around my hometown and maybe knock on some doors or email some relatives and ask them if they knew if their organization, their company, was offering a scholarship this year. So let me teach you my four-part process to finding local scholarships. Here we go. The first step is to Google. Just Google scholarships and type in the name of your hometown. Or if you're in college, type in the name of your hometown. That's one search. And the second search is to type in the name of the city or state your college is located in. Now, when you Google, let's say, for instance, I've been doing a lot of research on scholarships in New York, local scholarships in New York, and I am struggling to find them. I don't know if this is because New York is giving free tuition, or if I remember correctly, so a lot of these private organizations may not be offering scholarships anymore. I don't know, but I'm struggling to find them on Google. And so what I've started doing is researching local scholarships by the boroughs in New York and also the counties. So for instance, I told you Danville is a independent city in South Central Virginia, but Pennsylvania County borders Danville, Pennsylvania County. And so sometimes they may be offering scholarships, telling students in Pennsylvania County, hey, if you're from Pennsylvania County or Danville, you can apply for this scholarship. But if you don't look at the Pennsylvania County search on Google, if you don't Google that, you may not come across it. So you might have to search based on the city, state, search based on the county, based on the region. Danville is in the tobacco region. That's what it's also known as, or the Dan River region. All these different keywords and phrases to help you find these local scholarships. You also want to do community service, because you're going to meet people in your hometown or your college's hometown that will help you build relationships and therefore may connect you to more scholarships. So serve people, do community service. If you're applying for scholarships and you're trying to get a debt-free degree, or you're trying to graduate with little to no debt, you should be doing community service anyway, because that's what scholarship providers love to hear about in essays. That was the science behind me winning a lot of my scholarship essays, was my ability to talk about my service, my community service, and my selfless ambition. My desire to go do something in life, to make something of myself, but also ensure that I gave back to people along every step of my journey. So that's the second part. Now, calling people. I told you, I'm from Danville, Virginia. This applies to everyone, whether you're from New York City, Chicago, Danville, or a small town in Illinois. Call people, call these local businesses, these small businesses, and ask them if they're offering scholarships. It could be as simple as just saying, hey, I'm a student, a graduating senior at XYZ High School in XYZ City, and I want to know if your local business or company is offering a scholarship this year to students. Okay, you're not, Well, is it possible for you to give me a $100 grant to help me cover the cost of my textbooks? Oh, you can't do that? Well, are you willing to donate $10 toward the cost of my college education? I'm really trying my best to earn enough money to graduate with little to no debt. I've taken that route, and trust me, just calling people and asking them, letting them know who you are and what you're up to can open a lot of doors for you. And if you want to talk with me one-on-one about that, go ahead and use the link in the description box below to contact me. It's also on my website under the FAQ tab, Contact Danielle. Perfect way to talk with me, and I can walk you through that process. I might even shoot a video on it. And the last but not least, ask people if they're offering scholarships. Now, this is a little different than calling people, because when you ask, you may be at a ball game, you may be at your cousin's ball game, and you're standing beside a soccer mom, and you're like, hey, do you know if this soccer club is offering scholarships to seniors this year? Or is your company that you work at offering scholarships? Or is your church offering a scholarship? Or are you in an organization like a fraternity or a sorority? Are you all offering scholarships? You never know who you're around, especially in your local community. And so you just start to have a conversation and ask these people if they know if anyone is offering scholarships. Another tactic I encourage people to use is to be a walking billboard for what you need. For instance, if you watch my video, How to Pay for College Without Debt, in that video, I gave you 8 different ways to pay for college without having to ever take out a student loan. And I told you exactly what ways I use, the ways I use to pay for college without debt. Now, I also mentioned, and in that video, I shot it with the first t-shirt I ever designed in my life called Debt Free Student, and I put my company's logo on it. That's because I was a walking billboard for the fact that I was a debt-free student, and it helped me get more clients, it helped me win more scholarships. So be a walking billboard for what you need. It's the same principle as asking people. You could say vet in the making, or I need scholarships to pay for college, or from homeless to Harvard, from homeless to Howard. I don't know. You might want to check the licensing agreements for those companies and organizations and institutions to see if you can actually put their name on a t-shirt. But anyway, I'm just saying, be a walking billboard for what you need. You never know what door can open. Now, how do we make this practical? I can tell you to do these 4 things, and then you watch this video, you click off of it, and you don't do it. That's what most people will do. Why? Because self-help books have great information, self-help videos have great information, but they're rarely put to practice. They're really rarely tested by other people, and people put forth the effort to actually see if it works. So let me make it practical for you. Now, these numbers might scare you, or they may blow you away, but I'm gonna tell you straight up, this is exactly what I did. I'm telling you from experience, and I graduated debt-free. So when I say make it practical, what can you do every single day, month, to get these types of results? By results, I mean graduate debt-free. Here we go. Find 5 scholarships per day. You can start finding scholarships on Google. Find 5 scholarships per day. Like I said, Google scholarships in Danville, Virginia, scholarships in Pennsylvania County, stuff like that. And then you want to, if you do that, and that's based on these numbers right here, this is a monthly scholarship game plan I'm giving you. Let's say we base this on 30 days in a month, 4 weeks in that month. If you do that for every day in that month, you will have found 150 scholarships in 1 month. All right, now let's look at calling people. If you call 10 organizations a week, let's say you just call 2 businesses Monday through Friday. You only call 2 people every weekday. That's 10 organizations a week. You do that for 4 weeks in a month, you'll have called 40 organizations over the course of 1 month. Let's look at service and asking people. If you do 5 hours of community service per week, that will bring you to 20 hours of community service per month. That's 5 hours per week for 4 weeks, 20 hours per month. Now, asking people, if you ask 10 people per week, that's 2 people every weekday, Monday through Friday, if they know of anyone who's offering scholarships, you can do that for 4 weeks in a month. You've asked 40 people in 1 month. Now, this is another important fact I want you to catch right here. The peak time, the best time to apply for local scholarships is traditionally from January until April. That's when that local scholarship window is wide open. You can apply for as many as you want to. And they are typically closed after April. Now, every city, every scholarship is different, but I'm telling you what I know from experience. Let's say you did this process, this practical process of calling this amount of people per month and per day from January to April. You will have found 600 scholarships by the end of April. will have called 160 organizations, did 80 hours of community service, and asked 160 people. That is not difficult. Once again, you will have found 600 scholarships. And I only applied for 120 scholarships and won about 42 of them to graduate from college debt-free. You would have called 160 organizations, done 80 hours of community service, and asked 160 people. I'm going to teach you how to do that much community service in that short amount of time in another video. But if this video has helped you, drop a comment, let me know. Also, if you have any questions or concerns, let me know in the comment section. And join me every single Sunday at 3 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time as I go live to help you earn scholarships to go to college and graduate debt-free. I'll see you soon.